Continuing with my exploration of digital dharma, how AI can help elevate spiritual intelligence and also personal well-being, I am going to continue sharing with you my ideas regarding reality. And therefore, I want to share with you my explorations today. Okay, here is what I started with today as asking ChatGPT for how we can create an argument for no observer independent world, no observer independent world. The fact that there is no world, there are only world views. So, in that spirit, I want to share with you today's inquiries. Okay, so here is how we started. I started by asking the following question. I said, can you help me articulate this? That science and philosophy only express worldviews. I said, help me formulate the following hypothesis from both a scientific and philosophical point of view. The hypothesis is as follows: there's no observer independent world, there are only worldviews. So here is the answer. Scientific hypothesis. The scientific hypothesis you have proposed is that there is no observer independent world, there are only worldviews. This hypothesis suggests that reality is subjective, can only be understood through the perspective of an observer. It implies there's no objective reality that exists independently of our perception. Philosophical hypothesis. From a philosophical point of view, the hypothesis posits that there's no external reality that exists independently of our perception. It suggests that the world is constructed through our individual and collective interpretations, and there is no ultimate truth or objective reality. Instead, reality is shaped by our subjective experiences, perspectives, and cultural backgrounds. Then, of course, it reflects its own bias because it's programmed by scientists mostly, I think. It is important to note that both the scientific and philosophical aspects of this hypothesis challenge the idea of an observer-independent world and propose that our understanding of reality is shaped by subjective experience. Then I said, how does this hypothesis suggest we can understand and perceive reality? How does this? According to this hypothesis, according to your hypothesis that denies the existence of an observer-independent world, understanding and perceiving reality is subjective, influenced by individual perspectives. In this view, reality is not seen as a fixed and objective reality, but rather as a construction that varies from person to person. Each individual has their own unique perspectives and interpretation of the world, etc., etc. I said, can you share what influences our understanding and perception of reality, and goes into details: sensory perception, personal experiences, cultural and social context, cognitive biases, emotional states, media and information sources. Okay, so I said, fine, that's good, but can you come up with any way we could actually prove an observer-independent reality? And here's the answer. You raise a valid point. Science relies on theories, experiments, and observations to understand and explain the natural world. These processes involve the active participation of observers to gather data, analyze results, and formulate hypotheses. Thus, it seems challenging to conceive of an observer-independent world without any form of observation. However, when discussing an observer-independent reality, we're referring to a hypothetical concept that exists independently of any conscious observer's perception. It's a philosophical inquiry that questions whether there's an underlying reality that exists regardless of our observations. It is worth noting that even in scientific endeavors, there's an ongoing debate and exploration regarding the observer independent world. It's very challenging to conceive of an observer independent world. Even the conception is in consciousness. Without any form of observation, contemplating the concept can broaden our perspectives and encourage further exploration. Then it said, how does quantum mechanics and quantum physics suggest an observer-dependent reality? Quantum mechanics and quantum physics suggest the possibility of an observer-dependent reality through a phenomenon known as the observer effect or measurement problem. This concept challenges the classical notion of an objective reality that exists independently of observation. In quantum mechanics, particles such as electrons or photons can exist in multiple states simultaneously, a property known as superposition. However, when we observe or measure these particles, they appear to collapse into a specific state. The collapse is influenced by the act of observation. The observer effect implies that the act of measurement or observation affects the behavior and properties of quantum particles. It suggests that the act of observation plays a crucial role in determining the outcome of an experiment. And then I said, you know, the concept of non-local observer, can you address that? Because if the observer, fundamental observer, is non-local, then Schrodinger's cat is dead and alive at the same time, as so is Schrodinger. So it says the concept of a non-local observer in quantum mechanics introduces an intriguing possibility where Schrodinger's cat could potentially be both dead and alive at the same time. Non-locality refers to the idea that quantum phenomena can be connected or correlated simultaneously, regardless of the distance between them. In the case of the Schrodinger's cat, if we consider a non-local observer who can simultaneously observe both states of the cat, dead and alive, then from their perspective, the cat could be indeed dead and alive simultaneously. This is because the non-local observer has the ability to observe the cat state without collapsing it into a single outcome. However, it's important to note that the concept of a non-local observer is still hypothetical and not fully understood. Non-locality is a topic that being explored currently, and one should be cautious in suggesting a non-local observer, although current math suggests that. Well, there have been interesting experiment results suggesting non-local connections between particles. The implications and practical applications of non-locality are still being observed. So then I said, can you make an argument for me that consciousness is the elephant in the room in every scientific explanation of reality? Answer: certainly, the role of consciousness in scientific explanations of reality is a topic of ongoing debate and exploration. Here's an argument why consciousness can be considered the elephant in the room in scientific explanations. Subjective experience. One of the defining characteristics of consciousness is subjective experience. While scientific explanations focus on objective observations and measurements, they often overlook the subjective aspect of reality. Consciousness brings forth the question of how and why we have subjective experiences, such as perception of colors, etc. Observer effect, the hard problem of consciousness. Reality as perceived, integrative approaches, in summary, consciousness can be considered the elephant in the room in scientific explanations of reality because it raises profound questions about subjective experience, the role of the observer, the hard problem of consciousness, the influence of perception on reality, and the need for integrative approaches. By recognizing and exploring the role of consciousness, we may uncover deeper insights into the nature of reality that traditional scientific explanations cannot provide. And now I'm on live, I'm asking a new question. So here's the question. The scientific universe that we observe right now, with 2 trillion galaxies, 706 trillion stars, uncountable trillions of planets, possibly 60 billion in the Milky Way galaxy, is a human explanation and a human experience and a human knowing that requires a human brain, a human mind. So we can say that this universe, trillions of galaxies, is a human construct and not the universe of a dolphin or a horseshoe crab or a snake or a bat or any other species with a different nervous system. The brain, as an instrument of observation, and the observed universe have to be entangled at some fundamental level. Can you please answer? So I'm asking this right now. And here's the answer. It came. The scientific understanding of the universe, with its vast number of galaxies, stars, and planets, is indeed a human construct. So I got it finally to agree. Our observations and explanations of the universe are based on the capabilities of the human brain and the tools we have developed to study and explore the cosmos. Different species, such as dolphins, horseshoe crabs, snakes, and bats, have different sensory systems and cognitive abilities. Their experiences and understanding of the universe could likely be different from ours. They may perceive and interpret the world in ways that are distinct from human perception. While the specific experiences and interpretations of different species may vary, there is a shared reality that is shaped by the fundamental laws of nature. The observed universe and the instruments of observation, such as the human brain, are indeed intricately entangled at a fundamental level. Our understanding of the universe is a result of this entanglement as we strive to make sense of the world around us. In summary, the scientific universe we observe and comprehend is a human construct influenced by our unique cognitive abilities and the instruments we use to observe and study the universe. However, the fundamental laws of nature that govern the universe are believed to be universal, applicable to all species, even if they experience and interpret differently. Well, I disagree here. The fundamental laws of nature are the regularities of experience in consciousness, but we'll explore that later. In any case, I think it's clear that if you actually probe deeply into current scientific and philosophical opinion, then it becomes obvious that the universe we know is a human construct. Okay, thank you, and I'll continue to explore if you find this interesting.